To many Americans, Al Jazeera is still associated with the Osama bin Laden tapes, Middle Eastern ownership, and anti-American protests. And no matter how stellar and award-winning its reporters and journalism, convincing potential US viewers otherwise was always going to be tough. So when it came to launching the new, all-news Al Jazeera America, we knew we had to take a deeply strategic approach to communications and outreach. Given most US media outlets would focus on the emotional aspects of the channel, those that would be most troubling to Americans,
Jewish watchdog groups in the United States have...
And yet they're about to infiltrate America.
We positioned the launch of Al Jazeera America as a fact-based business story, a much-needed contribution to and investment in US media and journalism at a time when other networks were cutting back. We also focused attention on the highly respected on-air talent that was being hired to reassure and educate audiences about the channel's unbiased, non-partisan reporting.
Here's my thing. You don't have to love Al Jazeera. You don't even have to like them. But if you say they shouldn't be in American homes, there's something wrong with what you're thinking about this conversation.
And we took Al Jazeera America senior executives to cities where the channel was launching bureaus to develop relationships with officials, community groups, and local media. We also ran studio tours for business and financial reporters at the channel's flagship studios in New York and Washington, D.C. The strategy was a huge success. The campaign generated more than 1,100 positive or neutral placements. One outlet saying, "The new network offers serious news with no partisan wrangling and no tabloid fare." Since the launch, viewership has climbed steadily, and the channel was recently picked up for distribution by Time Warner Cable, now reaching almost half of all households across the US.
In an Al Jazeera exclusive.
There's more to it. Al Jazeera America.
To many Americans, Al Jazeera is still associated with the Osama bin Laden tapes, Middle Eastern ownership, and anti-American protests. And no matter how stellar and award-winning its reporters and journalism, convincing potential US viewers otherwise was always going to be tough. So when it came to launching the new, all-news Al Jazeera America, we knew we had to take a deeply strategic approach to communications and outreach. Given most US media outlets would focus on the emotional aspects of the channel, those that would be most troubling to Americans,
Jewish watchdog groups in the United States have...
And yet they're about to infiltrate America.
We positioned the launch of Al Jazeera America as a fact-based business story, a much-needed contribution to and investment in US media and journalism at a time when other networks were cutting back. We also focused attention on the highly respected on-air talent that was being hired to reassure and educate audiences about the channel's unbiased, non-partisan reporting.
Here's my thing. You don't have to love Al Jazeera. You don't even have to like them. But if you say they shouldn't be in American homes, there's something wrong with what you're thinking about this conversation.
And we took Al Jazeera America senior executives to cities where the channel was launching bureaus to develop relationships with officials, community groups, and local media. We also ran studio tours for business and financial reporters at the channel's flagship studios in New York and Washington, D.C. The strategy was a huge success. The campaign generated more than 1,100 positive or neutral placements. One outlet saying, "The new network offers serious news with no partisan wrangling and no tabloid fare." Since the launch, viewership has climbed steadily, and the channel was recently picked up for distribution by Time Warner Cable, now reaching almost half of all households across the US.
In an Al Jazeera exclusive.
There's more to it. Al Jazeera America.
IPOB. IPOB.
One family.
IPOB.
We are unstoppable.
Yes.
Unstoppable. Come on, deal with the matwas. They'll keep lying. Who's so funny while we're in the Yoruba? Son is published by Little Man, is that correct?
Yes, sir.
Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
They are doing more damaging work than Iwosa Fulani.
through misinformation and lying. Anytime I decide not to speak and keep quiet, in deference, not to the laws of the zoo, but in deference to Justice Binta Nyako, that gave me bail, they keep publishing lies about me, lies against me and IPOB, and that is why I will keep responding. They are the ones who are breaking the law, not me. You can see the lies they are publishing about me and IPOB. Me and Buhari, who should be afraid of each other? Me and the zoo police, who should be afraid of each other?
The zoo police!
Me and the zoo army, who should be afraid of each other?
The zoo army!
How dare somebody publish that I'm in hiding? Who is that idiot? Come on, I can go put your hand on you. From some newspaper, an Igbo man's paper, writing nonsense. What is the headline? That Biafra leader on the run. That is zoo journalism for you. That is why we have our own radio Biafra. That is why we have our own satellite television. That is why we have Biafra television. Because of lies and deception. I can stand and prove who I am, but Buhari cannot do the same thing. Because the man you're looking at on the television is not Buhari. His name is Jubil, he's from Sudan. After extensive plastic surgery, they brought him back. Taught him Buhari's mannerisms. And he came and deceived all of you. You cannot deceive him, Nnamdi Kanu. You cannot deceive IPOB. Yeah. It was not my wish to speak. But the more I keep quiet, the more they keep lying against me. That is why I must speak. I must defend IPOB. I am under oath to defend IPOB and I will do it. Don't mind the lies they are feeding you. Bunch of lies. If I have something to say, I will say it live. As is happening now. People want to sell their newspapers, they fabricate nonsense. I have spoken to one of some newspaper journalists this morning. I have told them that some of you Igbo people are the delay that Biafra is experiencing. If it's Hausa, Fulani, I can fight them to a standstill. Some of you Igbo men and journalists are the problems we are having. Look at what a newspaper editor published. For public consumption, they were writing about Benjamin Onwuka. Is he the Biafran leader?
No!
The editor of the newspaper is a Yoruba man, weekend editor of the Sun newspaper.
And some of you wonder why you don't have good roads, why you don't have good schools, why you don't have employment, why things are terrible. Because the people that you expect to guide and to know the opinions of the people, they are criminals. They are liars and vagabonds. Yesterday they wrote another rubbish. I was told by Punch newspaper that they said they are sending me police everywhere in case I want to escape. Do you see how stupid people are? Do you see how useless people actually are? Do you see why I castigate black African people? Do you now understand it?
Yes, sir.
Because they are stupid.
Yes.
Very useless. Me and the zoo, who will run from each other?
The zoo!
Me and the zoo, who will run from each other?
The zoo!
This is our land.
I have come to restore Biafra.
Yes,
I wasn't afraid of Buhari inside his law courts. Under lock and key in prison. It's now that I'm in my father's compound. Don't be afraid of anybody. We are dear friends. People should be afraid of us.
Yes.
We are IPOB. People should be afraid of us.
Yes.
Because after this encounter, the zoo can never be the same again.
Yes.
They think we are joking. That is the worst mistake Buhari ever made, was to arrest me.
Yes.
The worst mistake ever. I will break the zoo into pieces. Watch what is going to happen. It is too late for this damnable Lugardian creation. There is nothing anybody can do about it. Any nonsense you read from these papers, it is not from me, it is rubbish.
Yes, sir.
Telling me garbage. I am taking IPOB to Abuja on the 17th of next month for my court case. There will be 2 million people in Abuja.
Yes, sir.
Let me make this very clear to you. You are under oath.
Yes.
And by virtue of that oath, you are under direct order from me.
Yes.
Any day you wake up, you hear I've been arrested. Born Nigeria, thank you.
Yes, sir.